king of Israel to know wisdom and instructions, to perceive the words of understanding, to receive the instructions of wisdom.
So we want our people to receive the instructions of wisdom. And it's coming from one of our forefathers, Solomon, King Solomon, one of the wisest men to ever exist on the earth. He wants us to receive the instruction of wisdom. Read.
Justice and judgment.
Justice and judgment. We're living in a society where there is no justice and there is no righteous judgments going on. Right? Read.
And equity. To give stability.
Subtlety
to the simple.
So we're trying to give subtlety to the simple, right? Our people who don't know their nationality, they don't know who they are. We're trying to make y'all wise and crafty now, right? You got to be wise as a serpent and harmless as a dove out here in these streets, right? We're giving subtlety to the simple, right? Read.
To the young man, knowledge and discretion.
So to the young man, we're trying to give you knowledge and discretion. Be discreet out here in these streets, man. But you gotta have knowledge as well. What type of knowledge? Not just any old knowledge. Not knowledge from UNLV, right? Not knowledge from Notre Dame University, right? But knowledge of the Holy Bible. Knowledge of the commandments. Knowledge of your heritage. Knowledge of your history, right? Read.
A wise man will hear and will increase learning.
So a wise man gonna hear these words and he gonna increase his learning. Meaning you're gonna take this message that you hear tonight and you're gonna go back home and do your own study. Right? And you're gonna dedicate time out your day to study this word every day. Read.
And a man of understanding shall obtain unto wise counsel.
And if a man have understanding, you're going to hearken to wise counsel, right? You're not going to shoo it off. When somebody coming at you with truth, with knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, you're going to accept it. You're going to take heed to it. Unlike in today's time with our people, you try to give them righteous knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, and they try to cast it to the ground. They try to look at you like you crazy for telling them the truth or correcting them on situations that they deem to be right. Why? Because our people are pure in their own eyes. And you can't tell them nothing. Right? But a wise man, you're going to adhere to wise counsel, man. Right? Read.
To understand a proverb and the interpretation, the words of the wise and their dark sayings.
Right, so you want to get the proper interpretation of the scriptures. And you want to get the dark sayings, the mysteries of the Bibles that's in the midst of the scriptures as well. Right? Because we're not out here just giving you knowledge off the bat, right? We done studied. We done used our leisure time to get this wisdom so we could pass it along to our brothers and sisters, to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. That's why we out here. Right? To give our people the knowledge, wisdom, and understanding that they need to survive out here in these streets. Right? What verse is that? Read verse 7.
Verse 7. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction.
So the fear of the Lord, that's the beginning of knowledge. That's the beginning of wisdom, right? You got to have that healthy fear of the Most High. You got to fear and love him enough not to break his rules, man. The same way you feared your dad, right? Or whoever was your guardian. You know what I'm saying? You had to fear them in order to keep order, in order to be in subjection to their rules. When you're rebellious as hell and you're not scared of your parents, you're going to break all the rules in the house, man. They tell you to come in the house at 9 o'clock sharp. You're going to be in there at 9 o'clock sharp if you fear them. If you don't fear your parents, hey, you're going to stay out till 1, 2 in the morning, man, not worried about the consequences. Because you know they ain't going to do nothing to you. Right? The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but what? Fools despise wisdom and instruction. And that's our people. That's 2/3 of our people. A majority of our people of our people, they despise wise counsel. They despise the truth, man. Why? Because they have made lies their refuge. They don't believe that the world is going to end soon, man. They believe that this kingdom is going to continue on forever and forever, man. But that's not the case, right? Let me get that in 2 Peter 2 and 5.
This is the book of 2 Peter. This is the book of 2 Peter, chapter 2, verse 5.
Bring it out.
And spare not the old world, but save Noah, the eighth person, and preacher of righteousness, bringing in the flood upon the world of the ungodly.
Right, so in the time of Genesis, the Most High didn't spare the old world, right? He made a great flood happen on the earth and killed everybody, except for Noah and his family, right? If the Most High loved everybody, why did he kill everybody and only save 8 people? Because the rest of the world in its entirety was evil. They were celebrating pagan traditions. Wives wasn't submitting to their husbands, right? It was homosexuality running rampant in the streets. That's why the Most High had to destroy the world the first time. Violence was everywhere in the world, in the old world, right? Just like it is today. Violence is everywhere, man. Everywhere you look, you see somebody getting shot in the head, somebody getting put to death, children being killed. Over there in Israel and Gaza, you see children being bombed, the hospitals being bombed, children dying, people dying, because violence is running rampant in the earth. That's the same thing that happened, right? And now that's going into the first death, right? That's the first death. That's when the world died the first time, when the Most High flooded the earth, right? Now let's go into the second death. Bring that out, King. Revelation 20 and, 14?
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 20 and verse 14, and it reads,
bring it out.
And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire.
And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire, right? Death and hell will be cast into the lake of fire. Death and hell is America, right? Death and hell is America. Ain't nothing but death is promoted here in this land, right? Eating abominable foods, fornication, homosexuality, murder, covetousness, adultery, that's all death. The wages of sin is death. All that's gonna be cast into the lake of fire. Hell is a lower mind state, right? Hell is a condition in the mind, and it also means the grave. But in this instance, it means a lower state in the mind or the heart, right? When you're thinking depression, anxiety, stress, worry, panic, all that's hell. Death and hell, huh?
So in other words, the world.
The world, right, right. We living in hell right now in America, right? We in hell. We in actual hell. Satan's living room. We in Sin City. Satan's living room. Right? So death and hell is going to be cast into a lake of fire when the ICBM missiles come and turn America to the lake of fire. Right? All this is going to be burnt with fervent heat. Right? Read.
This is the second death.
And this is the second death. Right? Because the world died the first time with the flood, and the second death is going to be with fire. The Most High going to make it rain fire and brimstone. Right? Let me get 2 Esdras. Matter of fact, let me get 1 Samuel 99. And let me get 2 Esdras 2 and 20.
You know, the thing that we haven't had is there's a war that's been played that we haven't seen. We'll be there from this real war.
Yeah.
At the beginning, we had.
Say that again, King.
You know, it's in the Bible.
Say that.
It's in the Bible, too. I just don't know specifically where it's at.
What's that?
But it did speak. He did speak. Within the text that it was going to be a wage war,
talking about World War III.
A war wage that's never been seen by humankind.
Right, right. This war, the old war was fought with loud noise.
Yeah, like we had
but this war right here is going to be fought with fuels of fire.
We had missiles. The second one, now we got missiles that's going to come down, turn into fire, and it's going to fire into a crisp in an instant. No way. We ain't winning no war like that.
Right, that's the reason why we out here, because that's what's to come, and our people got to be prepared for what's to come. If you're not prepared, you're going to be destroyed with this kingdom, because you're following the ways of this world, of this beast system. You're falling for the tricks, the snares, and the traps. So us being the prophets or the servants of the Most High, we are here to bring clarity to our people. But in particularly for you tonight, because you're the only one sitting out here receiving the message. So the message is for you, but we got to paint a clear picture so you can see it. Right? Bring that out, King. 1 Samuel 9:9.
This is the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 9, verse 9.
Bring it out.
Before time in Israel, when a man went to inquire of God, thus he spake, come and let us go to the seer.
And let us go to who?
To the seer.
So right. So you right now you're inquiring of the Most High, right? Because you hearkening to the word. Right? And we speak and thus said the Lord. Not our own words. We read it from the Bible and giving you the sense of the scriptures. So in the times past, Israelites, so-called blacks, Latinos, Native and Seminole Indians, our people, when we wanted to inquire of the Lord, we would go to the seers, right? Those that could see the visions, those that can paint a clear picture and give you clarity of the word. In today's time, they're known as prophets, but finish that off.
For he that is now called a prophet.
For he now called the what?
A prophet was before time called the seer.
So back in the ancient world, we was called seers. Well, let us go to the seer to inquire of the Most High. Right? Should I go to Jerusalem and sell this donkey? Let me go inquire of a seer or a prophet so I can know what I gotta do. Should I go up the street and get into an altercation with this brother about my money? Let me go inquire of the Lord and go to a seer, which is known as a prophet now. Because we used to obtain to wise counsel in the ancient world before we made a move. Right?
I got a question.
Uh-huh.
Concerning prophets in general, biblically, prophets was the ones who...
You can speak up a little bit, I can't hear you.
I said, biblical text in reference when it comes to prophets, I thought was more along the lines of the people that he used in order to reveal forthcoming events.
Right.
Like he did with Peter, like he did with the rest of them.
Right, right. So forthcoming events goes into being a seer. Right, you got to be able to read it and then see it, right? You got to be able to read the word and interpret it and see it clearly and then convey that message to the people.
And that's what I wanted to elaborate on, because I was like, I've been dealing with like a couple other people, you see what I'm saying, and I keep up with it when I can, you know. I still fall off, but I do keep up when I can.
Uh-huh.
From what I've seen and what they broke down, yes, we definitely y'all doing exactly what they said we were supposed to. But I'm looking more along the lines of bringing it on par with a priest instead of a prophet.
Bringing it as a priest?
As a priest.
Uh-huh.
Because he said that he made us all his priests forever.
Yeah, kings
so
and priests,
with him
right.
Using the specific prophets that he did in the beginning, and then he sealed it until the end times where it would be revealed again. I'm looking at it like,
get that.
I'm looking at it because, yeah.
Because in this time, this through Christ.
Right, and that's why I'm looking at it like, with that fall along the line of the priest,
who's Christ to you?
Christ to me, the house high.
The house high. So when you go to Hebrews 1:1, and then I will bring out Revelation.
Bring it up. The book of Hebrews chapter 1 and verse 1. Bring it out. God, Yahweh, who at sundry times and in diverse manners spake in time past unto the fathers by the prophets.
By the who?
By the prophets. So in time past, the Most High used his prophets to speak. Right?
Right.
It's seers.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Read. Verse 2. Having these last days
this
spoken.
This is the last days.
These the last days that we're in right now. Read.
Last days spoken unto us by his Son, whom he have appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the worlds.
Right. So through HaMashiach Yehoshua, we have the ability to come out now and do the same thing that they did in ancient time. But we have a more different message than what they had in ancient time. Because their time wasn't come yet. Right?
Right.
We at the end of the world, or the end of an age, where rulership is going to be transitioned from the Edomites to the Israelites.
Yeah.
Right? And that's the message. Bring that out.
In
Romans.
Salakia
King. Romans.
What that was your pop's called?
Revelation 19:10. Bring that out.
This is the book of Revelations, chapter 19, verse 10.
Bring it out.
And I fell at his feet to worship him. And he said unto me, see thou, do it not. I am thy fellow servant, and of thy brethren that have the testimony of Yahusha. Worship God, for the testimony of Yahusha is the spirit of prophecy.
Right, so we out here with the spirit of prophecy, the testimony of our Lord HaMashiach Yehoshua, right? Because he's ultimately the reason why all this is going on, why everything is transpiring the way it is right now. Why there's war going on in the so-called Middle East that's about to spill over here, that's because the testimony of our Lord HaMashiach Yehoshua, which is the spirit of prophecy, right? What you were saying?
My bad.
You gotta stop smoking. That's your lungs rejecting that shit.
I know.
You know what I'm saying? That's why you cough when you smoke, cause your lungs reject it. But hold on, bring that out, yes. P.
God. This is the book of Hebrews, chapter 7, verse 22.
Bring it out.
By so much was Yahusha made a surety of a better testament. And they truly were many priests, because they were not suffered to continue by reason of death. But this man, because he continued ever, had an unchangeable priesthood. Wherefore he is able also to save them to the uttermost that come unto God by him. Speaking of Yahusha, seeing he ever liveth to make intercession for them. So priesthood through Yahusha, keeping the laws of Yahweh, is what we're doing today.
Yeah, I mean, he sent his son down the river to die, but he sent his son to die for the ancestors. They the ones who messed up the cycle. I was like, his son is a bridge for the generations to come that he promised Abraham through the promise.
So that
we pray through the son to get to the Father.
And in the Old Testament, the priest, we were under what, the Levitical priesthood, the tribe of Levi. They were the high priests in the nation of Israel. But in the New Testament, the priesthood was transitioned to Yahusha. He was from the tribe of Judah, which in Hebrews it also says that there wasn't a priest in the tribe of Judah before him. So he's the high priest from the tribe of Judah, Yahusha, who died for our sins, and so that we can carry his message along even after death. That's why I said he has an unchangeable priesthood, because we'll be saved through him.
But look, what he's saying, even with the spirit of prophecy, then we become prophets, because we prophesy what's going
to
happen to this place.
But he has to go through Yahusha.
We're coming in the authority of Yahusha.
I feel it.
Let me get that in 2 Ezra 2:20. What you were saying?
Well, he elaborated on that. So for my own confusion, you see what I'm saying? Look, I ain't got mine open. I got child open.
It's the book of 2 Ezra, chapter 20 and verse, chapter 2 and verse 20. Bring it out. It reads, do right in the widow, set aright the matter of the orphans, right? So we got to do right to the widows, right? And we got to set the matter right with the orphans, those that are fatherless, those that the women that don't have a husband. You got to do right by them. Read.
Give to the poor, shelter the forsaken.
So we got to give to the poor, those that are literally poor, and those that are poor in spirit, right? We got to give this word to them, right? Our people that are trotting down. Read.
Can I add something to that? Because when you're fatherless, that means that you don't have a father, right?
Right, right.
And who's our father?
The Most High.
Yahweh. And then who's the widow? If you don't have a husband, who's our husband in the Old Testament?
Right.
Yahweh.
Yeah, Yahweh, yeah.
Right? So, he goes, you know, like the Bible is always giving you two messages in one spirit.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, you have
literal and spiritual. Yeah.
So, in the spirit, we have to come back to Yahweh, and he sent the prophets out there so they can feed you, so you can come back to your father.
Come back to the marriage. Buy them back to the marriage.
Yeah. Makes sense, right?
Yeah. It all connects. Read.
Clothe the naked, heal the wounded, and the sick.
So we got to clothe the naked, those that are spiritually naked out here. We got to clothe you with these holy garments, with this word. Right? It said clothe the naked and what?
Clothe the naked, heal the wounded,
Heal the wounded and the sick. Right? You might not be physically shot up or physically wounded, but spiritually, you wounded out here. You destroyed. You know what I'm saying? You don't know which way is up. You don't know who your enemies are. You don't know what's the truth and what's the lie. You're confused. We got to heal the sick with this word. Right?
Laugh not a lame man to scorn.
Don't laugh a crippled man to scorn. Don't be sitting up here mocking and laughing at those that's crippled. Right? Read.
Exactly.
And let the blind come before me into the light. So you got to bring clearness to these people with these different ailments, right? The cripple, the widow, the orphan, the naked, the sick. We got to bring them to the light so they able to see the truth of the word. You're going to go into the church and thinking you're getting a message from the Most High. You're really getting a message from Satan. Because they're not telling you the truth. They're not bringing clarity to your sight. You're still blind.
Ain't that the reason he brought down the walls of Jericho?
Con. They brought down the walls of Jericho because
they were defiling the temple.
Right. They were sacrificing to idols, and the Most High gave us that land, right?
But he abolished everything that they know of Christianity.
right. So you got to cast down the idols, break down the strongholds, and that's how we bring clearness to your sight, right? That's what our assignment is. That's what our job is in today's time. Let me get Revelation 20 and 14 again, and you let me get 2 Peter 3 and 5, right? Just so we can get a little understanding on what's to come, what we're going to foresee, and show you what's to come, and pray that you get it right and turn back to the Most High before that day. Right? You got to stay up on it. You got to continuously read and apply what you read. Bring that out.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 20, verse 14.
Bring it out.
And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire.
So death and hell, which we established as America, going to be cast into the lake of fire. Meaning America is going to be turned into a lake of fire, right?
I mean, this is Babylon.
This is Babylon. Spiritual Sodom, spiritual Egypt. It's going to get burnt.
To be the last one that falls.
It's going to get burnt to crisp, right?
It's also the most powerful, which is why everybody brags about U.S. being the most big dog superpower state.
It's the most powerful, but the most wicked at the same time.
Babylon.
right. Land of confusion.
Everything else that happened everywhere around us, except for here again. Now it's going to get ready to come over. Why do you think we're the last ones to fall?
Right, read.
This It's the second death.
So when America get turned into a lake of fire, meaning it's going to be flooded with missiles, that's going to be the second death of the world, right? Bring that out, King.
This is the book of 2 Peter chapter 3 and verse 5, and it reads, "For this they willingly are ignorant of, that by the word of Yahweh the heavens were of old, and the earth standing out of the water and in the water."
So of old time in Genesis, when the world was flooded, the earth was standing in the water and out the water. Salakia. Read that part again. I got it twisted up.
"The heavens were of old, and the earth standing out of the water and in the water."
So the earth was standing out of the water and in the water in old times when the flood came. Right? So meaning there was mountains and hills. There was mountains and hills that was out of the water. And then once the flood came, they was in the water. Read.
"Whereby the world that then was being overflowed with water perished."
So the world that was died because it was flooded.
It got drowned.
Right? It got drowned. The world
like
was
when
drowned.
If you plant too much water, it ain't gonna be able to grow.
Right. Read.
"By the heavens and the earth which are now."
The heavens and the earth which are now, which is right now, read.
"By the same word are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and prediction of ungodly men."
Right, so right now, this word that we in right now is reserved in store for fire. Right, he preserving the world right now for fire, for ungodly men. Right, ungodly men are men that go against the commandment. Right, that break, that transgress the commandment. You know, today is the Sabbath day, right? Friday sundown to Saturday sundown is the Sabbath. Right, it's the 7 day of rest. We're not supposed to buy, we're not supposed to spend, we're not supposed to sell, we're not supposed to. Some brothers, we're not supposed to kindle a fire as far as cooking, right? We're not supposed to be doing servile work, working for hire on the Sabbath day, right? If you're doing those things, you're going to be nuke food, right? You're going to be destroyed with fire when this world gets destroyed. And that's just one of many things that you could be destroyed from, right? So we out here to feed Yahweh Shai's sheep and bid them back to the marriage so you can avoid death and destruction when the Most High come and show his wrath, right? Because we don't want you to be a part of the second death. You know what I'm saying? So we humbly out here, man. We don't have to be. We are called to do this, right? This is like a job outside of our regular job. You know what I'm saying? Right? Read. What verse is that?
Verse 8.
No, that's good. Let me get Isaiah 43 and 2. And let me get Amos 9 and 2. Right? Because the Most High going to protect us in that day. If you're doing his will, you're not going to have to worry about being burnt up with nuclear fire. You're going to be rejoicing. You're going to be celebrating, gathering with your brothers, sipping wine, being merry, while everything around you is being destroyed. Right? And that's what you want. Right, right. You ain't trying to get caught out there slipping, brother. Straight up. It's some fearful things to fall into the hands of the living power, man.
You're gonna say, bring let that me out. In, man. I'm gonna look at him like, you ain't coming in.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 43, verse 2.
Bring it out.
"When thou passest through the waters."
This is talking about Noah and his family, right? Read.
"I will be with thee."
When you pass through the waters, I will be with thee. That was Noah and his family. Read.
"And though the rivers, they shall not overflow thee."
And the river's not going to overflow you. Mean you're not going to be flooded. Noah and his family wasn't flooded because the Most High was with them on that journey during the flood. Right? Read.
"When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned."
So now, in today's time, when the second death happened, when we walk through the fire, we're not going to be burned, right? With everybody else, read.
"Neither shall the flame kindle upon thee."
Neither shall the flame kindle upon your body. when the nuclear war comes to America. When you turn back to the law, statutes, and commandments, when you have the testimony of Christ, the spirit of prophecy, he's not going to let no fire burn you. The same way he did with Noah and his family with the water, he's going to do for us with the fire.
That makes sense.
It's going to be two-thirds of our people that be destroyed. Because this covenant that we in, everybody outside of Israel is automatically wicked. They wasn't given the laws of God. This Bible is only about the contract between the children of Israel and the Most High. We're not concerned about all the other nations. We're only concerned about our people. Right? And that's the difference between us and the modern-day church. The church is worried about the whole world. The Most High not dealing with everybody in the world. He's only concerned about his children, and two-thirds of his children going to be put to death. The reality is, let's say us three right here is a part of the ratio, right? Two of us going to be destroyed. Only one of us going to make it out. And that's for every three people. You see, that's us. Every three people of black, so-called black, Latino and Native American descent is a part of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. That's who's under the covenant. So two-thirds of our own people is gonna die by the sword, nuclear missiles. Right? What verse is that? What verse is that? Read verse 3.
Verse 3. For I am the Lord thy God, the Holy One of Israel.
The Holy One of what?
Of Israel.
No, the Holy One of everybody.
The Holy One of Israel.
He's the Holy One of Israel, right? And that's it, read.
Thy Savior, I can
chapter 9 and verse 2. Bring it out. Though they dig into hell, thence shall my hand take them. Right, so though our adversaries, they dig into hell, meaning that they dig up and build bunkers to hide from the nuclear missile. You know, Elon Musk got bunkers. The nigga that made Facebook,
Mark Zuckerberg,
they got bunkers. They try to hide from the nuclear destruction. Read that from the top. This is Amos chapter 9 and verse 2. Though they dig into hell, they dig into the ground, read. Thence shall my hand take them. Though they climb up to the heaven, meaning they go to their little space stations, or, you know, they fly their little rockets trying to hide from the destruction, read. Thence will I bring them down. The Most High still gonna bring them down. He gonna snatch them out the holes of the ground. He gonna snatch them out the bunkers, and he gonna bring them down. They can't escape. Like Paul said, I would not have known lust if it wasn't for thou shalt not covet. So a lot of our people are ignorant. They don't really know right from wrong because they haven't studied the law. Now, some commandments we are programmed to keep from the beginning, right? Some people, they're not out here just murdering people. They're keeping that law, right? Some people out here just not stealing every day. They're keeping that commandment. But a lot of us, don't know the law, so we break the law because we are ignorant to it. That's why we're trying to get our people to turn back to the covenant of the Most High, keeping the commandments and keeping the faith in Christ before this second death happened.
I look at the word like I look at old school saying that somebody told me when I was young. Not to discredit y'all in any way for what y'all doing, because y'all doing right. But I'm pretty sure everybody that heard it heard when they say you can do a horse to the water, but you can't make it drink.
Right, right, right. That's what we said today.
Yeah, that's what we said today.
God. Can't make no drink. Let me get Psalm 58 and 6. And let me get 2 Peter 3 and 10. Buck and Sean, I'm going to close out with this. You know, so basically, brother, you know, you're a child of the Most High. You either from the tribe of Judah, Benjamin, or Levi. You know, I can't tell. I don't know how far your ancestors go back or whatever, but you're a child of the Most High, nevertheless.
So
you
got to repent. Either,
yeah, you got to repent.
I kind of wish I did.
You got to repent and keep the commandments. If this word is aligning with your spirit, you got to repent. Turn back to the laws, man, and start getting it right. Because it takes time. This ain't an overnight thing, right? Like they say, Rome wasn't built in a day. Repentance don't come instantly, man. You got some purging to do. You got to go through some affliction. You got to recognize your tribulations. You got to have a contrite spirit, contrite heart, and you got to turn back to the Most High fully. Not, a day here, a day there, a week here. No, you got to do this every day, consistently. And you got to start keeping the Sabbath. Right? Bring that out, kids.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 58, verse 6. Break their teeth, O God, in their mouth. Break out the great teeth of the young lions, O Lord.
So we got to pray to the Most High that he destroy our enemies. When it says break his teeth, meaning take his weapons from him. Break down his weapons. Just like a couple years back, Biden pulled the military out of Iran and left all the weaponry. You know what I'm saying? Millions of dollars, billions of dollars worth of weapons he left. That's the Most High breaking the teeth of our adversaries. Read that from the top.
Break their teeth, O God, in their mouth. Break out the great teeth of the young lions, O Lord.
And Esau, Edom, and the heathen nation, they're considered young lions because they're active, right? They turned up in these streets. They know what's going on. They moving around. They hunt their prey. They vicious, right? So we got to pray to the Most High continually for him to disarm our adversary. Because Esau's blessing was the sword. He need to be disarmed from that blessing, right? And then we can get his ass, right? Read. Verse 7.
Let them melt away as waters which run continually.
Let them melt away as waters that run continually. Read.
When he bended his bow to shoot his arrows.
When he bended his bow to shoot his arrows, meaning his missiles, right? When he put the missiles on them silos and they launched the missiles, that's the modern day bow and arrow. Read.
Let them be as cut in pieces.
And let them be as cut in pieces, destroyed. Read.
Verse 8. As a snail which melted, like every one of them pass away, like the untimely birth of a woman, that they may not see the sun.
Right. So we got to pray for their destruction. We got to pray that our enemies be destroyed speedily. Right? Because if not, it ain't going to be nobody to save. They're going to destroy the whole world till everybody's dead. You know what I'm saying? Because Esau got the mindset that if I'm going to die, or if I'm going to go out, I'm finna go out with a bang. I'm taking as many people with me as possible. Right? And that's what he's doing. He's taking a lot of our people with him. You know what I'm saying? So we gotta acknowledge the fact that we have enemies. We got to acknowledge the fact that our enemies are ruling over us right now. And we got to acknowledge the fact that we need the Most High to deliver us out of the hands of our enemies. Bring that out, King.
This is the book of 2 Peter, chapter 3 and verse 10. It reads, But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night.
So the day of the Lord going to come when everybody least expected, when ain't nobody paying attention. Read.
In the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise.
And the heavens gonna pass away with a great noise. That's that thermal nuclear destruction. Right? The heavens, there's different levels of heavens. You have the sky, which is considered the heaven. The heavens above the sky, right? Outer space, so to say. The third heaven. And then you have the heaven right here. This kingdom. It's our hell, but our enemies, this is their heaven. Right? The person that owned the stratosphere, this is his heaven. He making millions and billions of dollars doing nothing. Getting people money, he not worried about nothing. He not financially disabled. He prospering. This is their heaven. Right? But the heavens, read that again.
But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise.
So this kingdom is going to be destroyed. This heaven is going to be destroyed with a great noise. A lot of boom, boom, boom. It's going to be destroyed. Read.
And the elements shall melt with fervent heat.
And the elements shall melt with fervent heat. You know what the elements is, right? The air, the water, the rock, the mineral. Right. The elements going to melt with fervent heat. Read.
The earth also and the works that are therein shall be burnt up.
So all the evil works, the prostitution, the homosexuality, the damn drug use, the wicked rap music, the wicked entertainment industry, your Hollywood, all that's going to be burnt the hell up. Right? So it's our job to show our people the vision that the Most High gave us and bring clarity so you can see it. In hopes that you will repent, man. Hopes that you turn back to the laws, statutes, and the commandments of the Most High. You know what I'm saying? Forsake pagan holidays. Start keeping the holy days. That's real. Because you're a child of the Most High, man. How are you going to be? 31? All praises. You made it another year. But don't make that day about you. It's about him.
Call it a birthday. It's an earth day.
Right,
so
right, a special
means
day.
That you was born into this world and you took your first breath before you knew anything of right. I am no longer being birthed. I'm 31.
Right.
I'm not popping out of my mama. You see what I'm saying?
Right. You really only have one birthday. When you think about it, you only got one birthday. Yeah, but that brother in the spirit though, man.
It's like we not doing that in 2024.
Yeah, you in the spirit, man. You just gotta read more, apply more. And cut out distractions.
It's more so of applying what you learned.
Right,
like
right.
You're learning this, it's just applying it, bro. That's the hardest part for our people to apply these things. A lot of our people know about it. Oh, y'all the Israelites? Yeah, they say that, but they're not keeping nothing. They're just applying these
things. I mean, I keep as many as I can, but I still fall with a lot of them. I was going to say a couple. No, it's a lot of them.
Yeah, that's why you got to surround yourself with your fellow brethren.
You got to
surround yourself with your fellow brethren that's gonna build you up. And when you do fall, we're going to hold you up. We're going to pick you back up. That's why we out here. You know what I'm saying? The brother brought out, gather yourselves together, O nation I desire. You got to gather together with like-minded people.
That's
a spirit that prevented you from, you know.
I played a little bit of music. I listened to a little bit of music. And then I got drunk.
Yeah, the scriptures teach us not to be drunkards. It's all right to drink in moderation, but you can't be a drunkard. Right? But that's my time. That's my time, brother. I'm going to let our next mighty brother come up and speak and edify. You know what I'm saying? So, all praises and glorification to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah. It's HOY to the cherished flight, voice of Yahweh, Shalom.